Jake Ludington here at IBM Impact, and I'm here with Elena Nenos from Blue Cross Blue Shield. And you have been in IT for a few years, I take it.
Yeah, a little over 30.
And we're here, of course, at IBM Impact. And how long have you been working with things like WebSphere and Java and the ZOS?
I have been working with Java and ZOS for over 20 years. I've been working with CICS Transaction Gateway, MQ, and WebSphere. And WebSphere specifically over 15 years. And my main function right now, I'm a lead systems architect for HCSC, which is Blue Cross Blue Shield, and my main function right now is performance. So I spend a lot of time tuning WebSphere on ZOS and also on distributed. And here at Impact, I did two presentations. One was on CICS Transaction Gateway and ZOS. I did it on Monday, where I talked about how we consolidated 80 distributed CTG instances to ZOS, adding high availability and saving our company over $400,000, which was a real win-win situation.
And as a guy who works in business ops for my day job, I like to hear that there's money saving involved here.
No, seriously, we saved over $400,000. We reduced response time in half. And we created high availability architecture with a lot of failover using the latest releases and bells and whistles. And I have a whole talk on that, which I plan to download to WebSphere user group website so everybody can enjoy it. And the presentation I just did with Marcel from Canada Java Lab was on WebSphere and ZOS. And we just upgraded WebSphere and ZOS from version 7.0 to 8.5.5.1. And we had amazing results. We had, in general, a 30% CPU reduction. And we utilized the latest features like pageable large page support with Flash Express. We did a lot of tuning for our applications. We reduced our Java heap size to optimize compressed reference. We also did some tuning. The tuning itself, it gave us over 10% performance improvement. The presentation I just did has a lot of gotchas as well. We ran into some glitches, so I talked about which fixes everybody needs to install and watch out for, which features come out of the box, but you may not necessarily want to utilize. So a lot of good information there, and I have a lot of performance data from our environment. And next we're planning to go to WebSphere 8.5.5.2, which was GA this Monday, and that adds 7.1 support, and we're looking forward to additional performance gains of 10 to 20%. So doing this upgrade, it's saving us literally hundreds of thousands of dollars because we keep adding new workloads to WASZ, and we have a lot of cost avoidance by not buying additional ZAP capacity. So it was a tremendous win for us and a lot of savings. So we're very pleased.
Now when you look at, you're looking at performance enhancements that you got as a result of moving from one version to another version. But if somebody is looking at performance optimizations just more broadly, are there things where you can routinely see big wins in performance?
Yes. So what I talked about in this presentation is that you really need to tune your Java heap. So depending on what is your min-max, what is your nursery size, we saw drastic performance gains by just doing that. And that doesn't cost you anything, so just a little effort. And the tools we're using free tools. You can use PMAT, you can use ISA, which has a GC log analyzer. Both tools will analyze your GC logs. It will show you if your GC overhead is low. Like I was showing in the presentation, one application with some memory leak and GC overhead was 30%, which is extremely high. So you definitely want to recognize that by analyzing your logs using free tools. The application that I was talking about that we saw 30% improvement, we did the tuning, the GC overhead was under 1%, which is excellent. So we have some in-house tools that we're using. We're using Wiley, CA Wiley Interscope. We're using BMC Visualizer to see our CPU usage. So whatever tools you have, and some tools are free, make use of it, and I highly recommend that.
Excellent. Well, I look forward to seeing the presentations online when they're available.
Thank you. I appreciate that.